say, for instance, if he's being the person being blamed for the leak, well, the fact of the matter is that breaking TYM rules, no rule was him. I mean, he wasn't breaking any rules by leaking something, especially if he didn't post it himself on the forum. The consequence there for that would be that he would be punished, of course, legally by the company that was that he was bound to if there was an NDA signed. So that's not us to enforce. That's that company's job to enforce through whatever channels they choose to enforce it with. Your banning, I believe, had more to do with the fact that you were asked on a number of occasions to please, that we understood, at least the forum and the people on the forum understood your point of view and accepted your point of view. I think it had more to do with the exact same reason that I asked you during the Winter Brawl stream to not continue your constant bashing of MK9. We know you don't like MK9. We know why you don't like MK9. We accept that you don't like MK9. But there's no reason for you to stop other people from liking MK9.
My entire thing on the whole, like, getting on NRS and MK9's, like, jock is because I just want the game to be changed. If I didn't like the game, I wouldn't have bought it four times. I do like Mortal Kombat 9. I grew up playing Mortal Kombat 9. It means a lot to me.
So you grew up playing Mortal Kombat 9?
I'm sorry, I grew up playing Mortal Kombat. Some people may think I act like I grew up playing Mortal Kombat 9, but anyway.
Well, Webster, it's very obvious. It's very obvious that your passion for going after MK9 has nothing to do with the fact that you dislike it. It has more to do with the fact of what you want the game to be, as opposed you want to like it desperately.
That's definitely it.
You desperately want to like this game, and you have a problem with the game in the current situation, in the current state that it's in. So you want it changed. So the reason you're as verbal as you are about the game is because you want to see change. And I get that. The problem was is that, you know, it was constantly going after members on the forum. And now I'm not going to be able to give you specific instances. I know a lot of your posts were deleted. I know that you were banned. I know that you went off on people, so on and so forth. But it just is what it is. It was not my decision, but
No, I understand, Phil. I mean, but I think, you know, the one person that I know that I went off on and I went after was supposedly not even a real person, you know, from the information that I've gathered. So,
Birdsong?
That was Homeboy Tyson. Because that's the only. No, I never went after Birdsong, so that's Pig. But anyway.
Damn.
But, and I'm not trying to put him on blast or anything. That's just what I heard. Anyway, is that. You know, Homeboy Tyson was a real person. I felt at the moment, I mean, before I actually found it was funny that the song was offensive and stuff, even though, yes, he did make tons of songs about other people. And I'm sure after this podcast tonight, he's going to make another one about me. But anyway, it's just that. But that was a very short-term thing. I mean, it's not like I went to a tournament and backhanded the shit out of him into someone else's arcade stick. It's just that. You know, I was salty and I was verbal about it. But, you know, I don't think I actually broke a rule on TYM. I just felt like maybe they just, that I was banned. And it was without reason because no one gave me, like, any type of anything. I was just done.
Well, if it was for anything, it probably, and here they go again. If it was for anything, it may very well have been for the trolling rule, which, you know, we all know that the trolling rule is a very wide rule. It's very open to interpretation, and it can differ from moderator to moderator. Generally speaking, you want to keep trolling off your forums, or at least with Test Your Might. And as you, as a former moderator, know that during the time of MK9's real reign, we tried our best to keep trolling off the forum and keep the forum as competitive based as possible. So. You know, as I said, since it's such a wide range for interpretation on that rule, moderators, you know, interpret it differently from moderator to moderator. So
I understand that. And I also believe that, you know, I get it. You know, me being the vocal person that I am and saying nothing but negative things about the game, regardless if it's for change or not, I do understand for a forum that's not really the type of thing you're trying to present to either new people that come to the forums or people that are already there enjoying themselves. I understand that. That's why I really didn't make a huge deal out of being banned. And to be honest, I really don't care. You know, I do feel that maybe it was certain staff members who had maybe a personal vendetta against me. And that's okay, because there are many members of the community that go after me or think negative of me because of my opinion and how vocal I am about it. And, you know, I get that it can be deemed as annoying or disrespectful, but how the fuck is anything going to get changed if people are just quiet about it and just, you know, praying that it might happen? You know, I'm actually offended that not more MK players are not just as pissed off as I am and be vocal about it, because, you know, the Capcom players do that, and when they do it, they get the changes that they want. They keep making petitions, they keep going down Ono and the Marvel guy's throat, and Capcom makes it happen. And you cannot sit here and tell me that Warner Brothers is broke, because they make hella movies and they got tons of money. So, I mean, if anybody else works for them, how the fuck are they broke? How do they not have money to do these patches, to cater to the community? I mean, you give away tons of thousands of dollars to the players at tournaments. How do you not have money to patch shit? Or to give us an Ultimate MK9 or something? I don't want changes in MK and Injustice. That is not Mortal Kombat. I want these changes in Mortal Kombat, not Injustice. You know, that's just me, though. I mean, like Popo said, my opinion may not be, well, he made it sound like to me, from what I just saw at Paco Rhea, it doesn't really matter what I think, my opinion. But I am just one person. That's okay, because I know a lot of other people feel the same way I do, and I just wish that they would be more vocal about it so we can get what the fuck we need to get is a better MK game, a balanced one, a fun one, one that everyone in the fucking fighting game community can respect and that want to get into and dive into, because it is good without input bug or first player glitch or whatever the fuck people complain about, including me.
Man, I remember you when I went to Seasons Beatings and you were jumping up and down telling everybody the input bug doesn't exist.
Oh yeah.
And then it happened to you in match. You were playing a money match and you lost, I think, because of the input bug.
Yeah, and then that, and it all went downhill from there.
And that the controller at that point didn't survive the fight.
And neither did the stop sign. But see, that's okay. I mean, I can laugh about that because it's true. I mean, that's just MK. You should have saw me in my early Tekken 3 days, Tekken 2 days, where I just destroyed arcade machines. So that's nothing. But, you know, I'm putting myself on blast here. But, yeah, I do get salty. I'm the epitome of salt.
Hold on. There's a story out there somewhere of Jimmy doing the same thing to an MK4 machine. So,
yeah, well, I actually put my knee through the cabinet. Astronaut said something, and you know what? In a way, he's right. Why would NetherRealm cater to all 61 MK players who play competitively? Now, maybe the number's not right, but when you compare 3.5 million copies of a game being sold, you know, the 200 and something people that actually play competitively should not overweigh. If those other people aren't bitching about it, they're happy. You know what I'm saying? So you can't.
But those other people aren't the ones that are going to tournaments showcasing the game to the world,
to entertainment for who? For you?
For everybody. For you. It's not just the competitive players.
My brother's a year and a half older than me. He don't give a fuck what the hell a CD Junior is, or a Rio, or a Tom Brady, or even Apollo, or a Hector, for that matter. Is the game good? Yes. Okay, I'll sit at home and play it. You know, so, I mean, it doesn't matter as far as what that, not to say that it doesn't matter, because they do listen, you know, but, you know, you got to understand, people's hands are tied at times, too.
Right.
You know, so it comes down to, you know, there's no, you know, it's not like you could turn around and say, all right, you know, hey, NRS, this is what I want. I want, you know, this, and this. And that's what you're going to get, you know. You don't turn around and tell who, I don't know, Michelangelo, you paint the Sistine Chapel or some shit like that. You don't turn around to the dude and be like, yo, I want that girl's titties to be a C cup, and you know that one with the wings over there. You know, make the wings black, and you know, give her green eyes. He's the artist. He's the creator of it. Now you could choose not to like it, or you can choose to like it. But you know, it's all in the eyes of the artist at the end of the day. Mm-mm. And you know, beyond looking at, you know, video games as another form of entertainment, or you know, it's also a creative art, which you got to actually kind of say, hey, look, you know what, you didn't get what you want. That's because they didn't have the same vision.
Mm-hmm. Well, the way I look at it is that I feel that the dedicated MK players, the ones who are content with the game, are the ones that are the ones saying that, you know, kind of just put up with what you got and love this game for what it is. I get that. But then there's those very small amount of people that really want the game to be changed better, and people outside of the MK community looking in saying that this game is bullshit and this game needs to be fixed in order for me to give a fuck about it. But I guess, like you just said, I guess none of that matters because we're not the majority of casual folks who twiddle their fucking thumbs and jack off to Shiva fatalities, which is bullshit because, you know, people like me, you know, want a better game, a better fighting game with a better engine. And I know some of you guys are thinking, well, fuck you, Digi, the game's already good with the good system mechanics and all that shit, but whatever. I mean, that's why, you know, today I will announce I'm going to try very hard to slow down on the bashing on forums and stuff. Well, not forums. I can't go on TYM anymore. But on, like, chats and shit, I will try to slow down, especially since Injustice is coming out soon. And I guess a lot of people are going to move on. But I'm going to tell you all right fucking now that that's bullshit. And I hate that. I hate that the fixes in MK9 get changed to a fucking new game or new brand than actually getting them fixed in the game that we want to fucking play and continue to play to be better.
I don't think everybody's going to move on. I think it's going to be, you know, people playing both games.
Nah, I don't think so.
Why
very
not?
Very small. While it was a good game, a good attractant, you know, in the beginning, look at how it dropped off already. I mean, just look at the numbers. You know, where's the that level of hype that existed Lacidi Jr. I mean, he hasn't played. Max, they don't play that much anymore. Rio hasn't been playing that much. I mean, it's just, you know, and I've been saying this from day one, the average game has a lifespan of 18 months. This surpassed that 18 months. That makes it a success. But it's never going to have the, you know, impact that MK 1, 2, and 3 had on the rest of the franchise.
Get it right, Jimmy. It's Ultimate.
Are you guys reading this shit Paco is saying? Come on, man. Paco, dude, seriously. The things that are fucked up in MK9, all the issues that I bitched about, everyone else has bitched about, you have looked into it and you have changed all of it to make sure it doesn't even exist in Injustice. Don't give me that MK9's issue has nothing to do with what's in Injustice. That's bullshit. Get on this fucking stream, get on this fucking podcast and tell me to my goddamn ears that that's not the same fucking shit. Come on.
Whoa, hold on, Webstar. And then I'm not sitting here standing up for Paulo. I'm standing up in general about what you just said. If you're anything, whatever you do for a living, and you do something, like I make trophies for a living, right? So let's say today, or, you know, or I make trophies and plaques and awards. Let's say today I make an acrylic, and the acrylic looks great, but it's not 100% the way I want it, but the customer wants another acrylic in a week, but they want it to say something different, or maybe to be a plaque. Well, the plaque is an entirely separate job, an entirely separate piece, an entirely, you know, the way it's set up is my own art. I'm the person actually creating it. Bird, shut up.
Kill that fucking bird,
even
man.
Me now. So why would I not take a look at my past work as a reference point on what I can improve in the future? And that goes for everything, not just me making awards or NRS making games. Anything that they realize they may have screwed up in MK9, it would be stupid to not make an attempt to fix that going forward with any game they create, not just Injustice or MK10 or whatever.
That's my point. I just thought he was making it seem like that wasn't what he was saying. That's all I just said.
Hey, Phil. How the fuck do you sleep in that house with that annoying bird?
as soon as the light goes out, the birds go to... Well, that's really not true. As soon as the light goes out and I stop talking, the birds go to sleep.
So they never sleep then?
No, when I stop talking.
When I go to bed...
Yeah, they never sleep then.
When I go to bed, I put the fucking a plastic bag over its head.
Damn.
I like Paco is on here just trying to trash Tekken. Keep doing that, man. That's it. he hates Tekken, I guess. He hates a better fighting game than his. That's I don't blame you for being salty, brother. I'm sorry.
I hate Tekken too, bro.
Alright, so I'm gonna do this. I am going to give anybody in the audience that wants to Drill Webster, I'm giving you your opportunity right now to come on the show and do it, or forever hold your peace.
But
and
just
stop
know,
with the hate.
I will defend myself.
Oh yeah, that's no problem.
Because I mean, I it's one thing to post on TYM where I can't fucking say nothing, but you come on here talking crazy, best believe we will have a conversation.
I'm going to give you guys a couple of minutes. If not, I'm going to switch this over, run a couple of more commercials, and I want to start getting some of these anime cats on the show. Because really, this show
anime.
Is...
Anime!
This... I want the little freaking Asian schoolgirls running around fucking shooting fireballs.
Oh, yeah. I was told
Brady wants to come back on.
Hey, Jimmy?
Yeah.
I'm going to get going because I got a little bit more work to do in my office before I run. But I got two quick things that I want to mention. If you don't mind me plugging the two Combat Network things coming up. All right. So we got three things coming up in the relatively near future. On April 16th, the release date of Injustice at the Gamer's Edge. There'll be a VSM release day party. It'll be an all-day thing from the day from the moment that the doors at the Gamer's Edge open until we close, which will probably be 2 a.m. So there will be multiple systems. Multiple copies of Injustice prepared, ready to go, ready to be played. I will have my stream up at some point. We will be streaming Injustice, and it'll be an all-day thing. There's no guarantee on a venue fee just yet. I think it will be a free event for people to come and enjoy and try out Injustice and enjoy it and have a good time. The next one is about 10 days later. On April 27th will be the first Combat Network Injustice tournament at Yestercades called Project Injustice, which is continuing to use the theme of older games to name the tournaments at Yestercades that involve Mortal Kombat or Injustice. So Project Injustice, April 27th at Yestercades in Red Bank, New Jersey. And then lastly, on May 11th, and Natus, I'm sorry, I didn't get you the splash page for it, but it is ready. April 11th, we have On the Edge 3, which is the local that we hold 1 to 2 times a year at the Gamer's Edge. It is the second ECT qualifier. It's an ECT 5 qualifier for Mortal Kombat 9, Injustice, and King of Fighters 13. King of Fighters 13 being run by the group Kick Punch Block. They'll be handling everything, including a stream for that. We will have Combat Network will have Mortal Kombat 9 and Injustice running on 2 separate streams, Combat Network and Combat Network 2. All 3 games will get... the winners, first place, will get free venue fee, free game entry fee, and free and seating to their game that they win in. And I'm currently in the works. I've already got it from Testermite and MKU. I'm waiting on a couple of other organizations to get back to me, Jimmy and Natus. Not going to name names there, about extra venue fees that we will be providing to other players who accomplish other feats throughout the tournament. So we will have other venue fees to give out for ECT as well at On the Edge 3, which is May 11th at the Gamer's Edge. It's a Saturday. Tournaments will start by 2 p.m. Doors will be open for casuals by noon.
And test your mic and blow me.
Oh, boy.
Here we go. Hey, fuck them. You know what?
They can you know what? Storms, if you ask us, send us a message asking if we said anything, yes, we did.
Yes. Hey, you know what? You don't have to go to somebody else. I told you to suck my dick. I don't know who you think you are. I don't like how you talk to me. You look like a motherfucker that should be in the movie Twilight. Suck my dick. Lick my balls.
You know, I don't really like him either, to tell you the truth. I mean,
For me, it's the silent jabs. Keep your silent jabs. Keep your silent jabs silent. When I start to hear them, now I get pissed. Very simple. So, you know, like I said, will I get banned for that? Because I didn't do that. Hey, I can't be banned for telling them to suck my dick on my show.
Already
yes, you can.
How can I?
Because it's
I didn't violate a rule. What is it? No freedom of speech rule outside of the Test Your Mic community?
Fuck no, man. You got to suck his dick in order to stay there.
He's shit out of luck for that. He's got a wife that can do that for him.
There you go.
He has a wife?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, but I mean, it's like I said, you know, I'm not going to harp on it too much longer because I got other things I got to move on to, but.
Brady wanted to get on again.
I'll add Brady again. And once again, as I add Brady, guys, suck my dick, test your mic.
I swear, when Brady goes, hand that shit is funny.
Guys,
this.
I'm out. I'll talk to you all later.
See you later, Phil. It's always a pleasure.
All right, Phil.
Likewise, guys. Good night.
Oh, so for the record, someone asked me, am I going to play Injustice? Yes, I'm going to play that fucking game. I don't know how I'm going to get it. I'm not paying for it. someone is going to pay me.
Yeah, who's not going to play it, man? Everybody wants to play it.
You got
to
add him. You know what? You got to add him again.
I do? You don't have him on your list again?
Let me see. Hold on. Let's see if he's in this list of fucking people here. I don't feel... Fucking Tom's afraid to have me on his fucking list and shit.
Dude, Injustice is going to be amazing.
All right, Adam, just click his name.
I hope it doesn't suck completely.
I hope it swallows more than sucks.
But you know what? What the fuck? Did you see that, Chandler? What the fuck is that?
Yeah, can we get a mod?
Yo.
Yo.
Yo, what's up, guys? First of all, what's going on? Did you hear? I hear your opinion, you know, about the game. So let me just say, I will defend these guys another round to my fucking dying breath. You have to understand, you know, Mortal Kombat and a lot of their games, they have... First of all, it's not even the same people. It's not like it's the same... Like Tekken and those guys, it's all the same people all doing the same things. But Mortal Kombat has gone through several changes as far as who the designer, lead designers are, producers, yada, 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 so on and so forth. And with MK9, everything kind of got changed around. You know, like, if I hear something like, hey, what's going on with MK versus DC, you know, John Edwards or Paul will say, well, we weren't the lead design then, yada, 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 you know, something like that. I mean, you guys are putting a lot of stuff, you know, on people, like, you know, well, because this game was whatever, that game was whatever. First of all, those guys weren't even, you have to understand, you got to put yourself in their position. First of all, when anyone wants to come on here and say, fuck games like MKDC, yada, 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 if it wasn't for games like that, you wouldn't even have a fucking game right now, all right? I mean, yes, people got to realize right now, I mean, a lot of those games, those different times, you know, you have Midway, who, you know, was in a money crunch, that's no secret, obviously, and a game like that kept the company afloat until there was a merger. I mean, after that, I mean, basically, I mean, I don't really know how it was, but I know, you know, everything was different, and, you know, the way the games were designed and yada, 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 all changed over, and they started saying, basically, once they got Warner Brothers, then they were able to actually say, let's make a tournament-worthy fighting game. Mortal Kombat 9 was the first time they ever used that specific type of, you know, it went back to 2D, there are a lot of, it's not like Street Fighter, who kept the 2D engine and did Ryu 1,000 times over. Whenever I hear someone say, look, I've been known to complain about Cyrex too, but this is the first time they put Cyrex in that engine. Don't fucking tell me that it is unrealistic that the first time somebody does something, there are going to be things to be worked out. And it is unfair to look at them and say, well, you guys just don't know how to do anything right. That's the first time they try to do something, man. There's obviously going to be things that it, and Paulo's right. Cyrex has never won a major, which is very true. he's weak. Too good, Paulo. Too good. I mean,
dude, they did do... Wait. They did do Arch Rivals, which was, like, the perfect basketball game ever. So you can't say they
never... You know what I mean? Look, this design team, you know, they haven't been together. MK9 is the first time they were all together in the fashion that they are right now. And this was you know, the first time in years. I mean, I didn't even know in the arcade era that they said, you know, look, first of all, you got to understand, the primary focus on game companies, Namco's primary focus is to make money, not to make your fans happy. You know, I was at, let me tell you something, man. I was at, there was a time when I guess in early MK9, even I criticized NRS for some of the things. You know, but, you know, why is this block hidden in the game? Why is this not being fixed? Why is that not being fixed? And in reality, I don't know shit about how things get changed or how long things, you know, how long it takes or even what they have to do to change things. So, obviously, I was just speaking about things I have no idea. But when I was at CEO, the first CEO, there's Harada there, you know. And I'm sitting there with Fab and GM, and I go, hey, man, isn't that Harada right there? The main guy in Tekken? They go, yeah. I go, man, why don't you go tell him some stuff about the game? Why, you know, let him know what you think, man. You know, you guys always tell me, why don't you tell Harada, you know? So he went over, and Fab and GM go over, and they're like, oh, what's up, Harada? Harada grabs his camera guy, and he's like, oh, and there's a peace sign, takes a picture. I'm like, he thought you guys were a bunch of scrubs. Get here to take a fucking picture. He doesn't know who you are. He doesn't care who you are. You know? These guys at NetherRealm, you know, they watch our streams. They watch us play. You know, you guys don't fucking think, you guys really think that those guys over at NetherRealm sit there and bug that you guys complain about? You think they sit there and say, oh, it's fine, you know, fuck it there. I mean, look, man, things happen, you know. It was the first time I tried to make a tournament-worthy game. And then people that haven't even played Injustice or have played, like, a build where the game was still in the alpha form, like probably Chaotic, God knows how old that build was. She probably was fucking playing the E3 build, you know. You know, you sit there and watch that shit and go, oh, yeah, dog, same shit's going on all over again. It's not even fair. You're crucifying a company, you know, who basically actually cares about the people that play it, which is something I can't say for anybody else who makes games. And not only that, they want a game, right? They want to make a tournament worthy fighting game. It is important for them to do that. You notice with MK9, you know when they patched it, you know, several times? They didn't patch it several times because, you know, oh, we just figured we'll make a patch one day. They patch it because they listen to people. But, you know, you guys, people that get on the NRS for all the patches, they should get on themselves because they're the one that fucking asked for it. I don't want to hear about how Cabal is broken because, you know what? Maybe if you guys were crying about Cabal instead of crying about everybody else, he'd have got his ass patched too. You know, that's the problem, man. You guys got what you asked for, and then you blame NetherRealm Studios for it. You know, get the fuck out of here with that shit, man. You know? And then you want to bury them for Injustice when it's not even out yet? Get out of here, man. These guys are people just like you and me, you know? They work hard at what they do.
Bullshit. Paulo is half cyborg.
Paulo is half cyborg, that's true. But for these guys to go in there, look, I was there for a week in MK9. And in that 1 week I was there, I don't think I saw Paulo go home once. Or John go home once. These guys have wives and families, and they bust their ass so that you guys can have fun playing a fucking game at tournaments. Do you understand how hard it's? I mean, I had no idea. I had no idea. I was like, wow, Jesus Christ, man, you guys don't go home? And they're like, crunch time, man. I mean, and these guys still find time to watch our stream. When the game comes up, they can say, fuck these guys, man. Swallow it up, bitch. No. I listen to our opinions. They come on the site. They watch our streams. They watch our tournaments. They interact with us. They go to Vegas with us. You know, Hector and those NRS guys, I don't know about this year, but I know when I go to EVA, at least the first one, I know for a fact, they went on their own money and hung out with us. Are you kidding me? Don't ever think that any other developer is doing that for their fucking their audience. Don't ever think that way. Sitting in the crowd at the first Evo of Mortal Kombat, sitting down with the rest of us fucking players, cheering for everyone else in the top 8, just like all of us. And to sit there and shit on those guys? No. And to sit there and the game is not even out yet. Injustice is not even out yet, and to say, why bother playing him? I don't want to play Injustice. I don't want to play DC Comic Book Heroes. I don't want, which will go see Man of Steel, but you don't want to fucking play him. Get the fuck out of here, man. You know, people love comic book heroes. They love superheroes. I don't give a fuck if it's Marvel or DC. Every little kid wanted to be Superman or Spider-Man or the Hulk or Batman. I don't care if it's Marvel or DC. Bottom line, people love their heroes. It doesn't make a difference. And sit here and just say, because a couple of things slip. And, you know, look, you got to understand. It's not like NetherRealm doesn't want to get things right. You guys as a community ask them for 90 million patches. If they don't know what causes something, they can't fix it. When some idiot like myself goes out there and says, input bug, I'm not really doing anyone any favors. I'm sitting here saying, hey, this happens sometimes. I can't tell you how it happens or how to duplicate it, but you better fix it. Do you know how stupid I sound? Are people that actually have the power to fix something? Let me get this straight. You want me to fix something, but you can't tell me what it is I should fix or what makes it happen or when it happens. You understand what I'm saying? And you have to know what causes something to fix it. People that want to sit there and blast NetherRealm for random advantage and player one advantage and input bug need to realize one thing. By the time people really realize exactly what the input bug was and what caused it and when it happened, the last patch had been released. By the time everybody found out all the random advantage and what caused it, the last patch had already been released. By the time player one advantage was discovered, the last patch had already been released. The bottom line is, these guys at NRS, they still have bosses. They work for people. And they can want to patch it once they figure out how to fix everything. Once they said, okay, now that we can finally duplicate everything and fix everything, it's not their decision. They have bosses who decide if something gets patched or not. So by the time all the information was available, the last patch was out. So to blast these guys and say they don't know how to do this or they don't know how to do that, you should be blasting the community for saying, you know what, guys? Maybe if you guys didn't hit up NetherRealm every day on Twitter and Facebook to change something because you don't like getting beat 50 straight, maybe they wouldn't have patched the game that many times and there would have been another one coming. It's just as much everyone else's fault. NetherRealm always gets fucking blamed. It's ridiculous.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I get what you're saying, Tom. I hear you, and I know a lot of what you said has to do with me, because I'm definitely a prime, person that's been beating fucking NetherRealm's door down. But, I know that ever since the Armageddon days, Armageddon DC and MK9, they have somewhat tried to make the game a little bit more than just casual. You can't sit here and tell me that.
Are you serious? Are you serious? A game that has creative combat, chess combat, and motor combat tried to make the game somewhat serious.
Are you telling me that they didn't put in mechanics that they didn't try to make it a legit fighting game?
Are you telling me that the people that... Let me tell you right now. You know what? You guys don't know that Paolo is a designer now. And, he's too busy to even try to get high level. Apollo is a very good fighting game player. He's a very high level player. As are guys like Brian LeBaron. And a lot of guys that are over there are working at fucking studios and fighting game players. You think those guys are too stupid to find universal infinites? Obviously they can. But it's not... But the game was not being made now. They are look what they're doing right now. Look how much exposure their games are getting. Look at the efforts they're going to making sure their games are at high level. You didn't see that back then. Don't tell me that these guys were equally putting that kind of... It's not even the same guys behind it. It's not the same designers. It's not even the same testers that were involved with Armageddon. So to even put Armageddon in the same breath as the guys that are working on this game now is wrong. And to judge these guys based off that is wrong. Don't you understand? Mortal Kombat 9 was a step in the right direction. Look, every game has their buggy things. Every game has got something absolutely fucking stupid. And we're fighting game players. So you know what that means? That means we complain more than anybody else. That's what fighting game players do. We complain. We cry. We're salty. We bitch. We piss and moan. And then we call each other out for pissing and moaning when we all piss and moan ourselves. And that's what we do. That's what makes us unique. I mean, that's what makes competitors unique. If you weren't salty and you didn't piss and moan, then you wouldn't care. And if you don't care, you wouldn't have the drive to win. So to sit there and put all this on NRS, when the bottom line is MK9, minus some of the bugs, which a lot of other games also have their own bugs in their own, weird way. You got Tekken that has mid crushes. You have moves that crush Bob's headbutt. It beats lows, it beats highs, and it'll even beat mids. But it's not a mid crush. See, every game has its little quirks. And I mean every game. And I mean every game. But it was a step in the right direction. It was the first time I've ever heard anything coming out of, you know, well, I guess NRS, which is Midway NRS now, you know, whatever, saying, hey, we're going to make a game for the hardcore community. They care that the game gets to Evo. They care that the game's at MLG. Fucking Hector was at MLG? Was it Anaheim? Are you serious? Do you think he was there because he was just in California to hang out, you know, with a couple of his friends? No, he was there for us. Support our scene. You guys don't think those guys are busy enough as it is when they're working on Injustice, and this guy's going to fucking take time, and if this guy's he's in school, he's fucking, you know, God knows how many, I mean, those guys probably, like I said, when I was there for MK9, those guys didn't go home ever. These guys are doing all this shit, and then he takes time to support our scene, and what do we say to these guys? Yeah, dog. MK9 or whatever, and Injustice, who'd want to play that game? Let's all play Tekken. I won that game, it's fucking just as gimmicky, and by the way, those guys don't give a fuck about it. And you know, MK9's not gimmicky. MK9 has no comeback factor. That's the biggest thing that every other fighting game has. MK9 does so many things right. If we as a community, we don't want to focus on everything that does right. All we want to point to is a couple of bugs. And then we go to people want to go to other games and excuse every fucking bug out there just so we can kiss the ass of those communities because they're a little bigger than Mortal Kombat. Let me tell you something right now. Besides the Capcom umbrella, the Mortal Kombat scene is bigger than any other fighting game. We draw bigger numbers than every other fighting game. We draw bigger stream numbers than every other fighting game. Let's go to the Capcom umbrella. You don't have to go to any other fucking fighting game. You don't have to go to Tekken. You don't have to go to Virtua Fighter. You want to play Virtua Fighter? You play with those other six people that play Virtua Fighter. You can play the game you love. You can play Mortal Kombat and actually be a respected fighting game player and have a competitive scene because you got people sitting in that studio who care enough that you have a competitive fucking scene. And they help us have a competitive scene. And they work hard to make their games competitive. And they're fucking humans. They make mistakes sometimes. That's not the first time they all come together to try to make a tournament game for us. So we fucking crucify them for that. And then when a new game comes out, we don't even give it a chance. We assume it's going to be just like Mortal Kombat 9 and crucify them for that too. That's wrong. That is 100% wrong.
That isn't wrong. I don't know, man. I just don't see everything that you're saying. I still feel that MK9 is an unfinished product. I think that the developers had more than enough chances throughout the 20 years they've been doing what the fuck they do to make fighting games. And if you're going to tell me, yeah, this is maybe their first attempt at a tournament-worthy game, but it's just not enough. It's bullshit. I mean, I don't know. Maybe, like I said, maybe I'm just spoiled with Tekken. A balanced game with a great wake-up, with a great Uki system. Knockdowns matter.
Wait a minute. Look, man. Look, obviously, you know, I have a lot of good friends that are good, and I'm not the best Tekken player in the world. I'll never claim to be. In Tekken 6, I was a good player. I wasn't as good as Fab. Hold on, let me finish. I wasn't as good as Fab in Core or GM, but I placed top three in a couple of pretty rough-sized season one of season beatings, a summer jam. I finished under Fab and GM several times in majors. Let me just say that, you know, those guys were better than me, but I was just under that level. I have a good understanding of that engine.
I know.
Tekken is not balanced because it's a perfectly made fighting game. It's balanced because they decided to make every character really gimmicky. That's not good. They decided to make the game where you can't possibly defend against everything. They made a game where the lesser player has a really high chance. They even made a range system where the creator, Harada, said, I made range so that the lesser player always has a good chance against the high-level player. But the guys at NRS, they don't think that way. They don't sit there and say, you know, we made MK9 so that the lesser player can, you know, can beat you. A game that is balanced by making it so it's impossible to defend against everything, that's not balanced. That's a game that has a very gimmicky fundamental flaw.
Are you talking about the crush system? I think that's what you're hinting at. You're trying
to say I'm talking about a lot of things. Low light speed launchers that you can't see. Hop kicks that are basically a slap on the wrist for punishment. Get the fuck out of here. I could go on for days, but I'm not. I don't want to. The bottom line is, it's an illusion. A lot of these players are just as frustrated with their games. They complain just as much about their games as you're complaining now in MK9. And you put those games up on a pedestal. I don't see you in those communities, Dizzy. I don't see you on the front line of those tournaments. I don't see you sitting there next to Core or anyone else or GM or Fab. When I'm hanging out with all those guys and they're telling me about the game, I don't see Digimon there hearing all the problems about the game. You know, you hear the rosy stories, but you don't share the shitty story. But, no, the game is... There are a lot of Tekken players that have even come to me to say, you know what, if MK9 didn't have some of the, you know, they don't like the hitboxes, they don't like the low hitboxes, they don't like some of the collision issues. But they've always said, outside of some of the bugs, it's the most consistent fighting game out there. And they've even said, it's probably the most consistent fighting game out there in general. We just don't like input bug, random advantage, yada, yada, yada. I feel like that's what they tell me. You know, obviously, that kind of stuff, they learned what causes those problems after the last patch, so they couldn't fix it because they... You can't just say, hey, dog, here's an... Look, again, I was way out of line. I'm sitting here ranting about an input bug. What good am I really doing? Am I really helping at all? I'm ranting about something that I can't really describe, that I can't say how or when happens, and yet I'm going to get on someone to fix something that I can't tell them how it happened. You know, I mean, that's ludicrous on my part. But the rest of the people, they don't think that way. They don't realize, what they're asking. You know.
May I interject for 1 second on your behalf, Brady? And Brady, yeah. Rake, please, well, actually, you got to talk after the arm blast.
Shout out to Triforce.
Well, I just want to say something about Mortal Kombat and something about the fighting game community as a whole.
Okay, wait. Let me go make a sandwich really quick.
Everybody got to shut up for a second. As everybody sees on the stream, I am smoking a fucking cigarette.
James, why are you doing that?
Because I'm in the mood to.
Oh, okay. That's not good.
The reason, there's something that's important that Brady's hit on a lot of points. However, and this is not to undermine Brady's point, those points in the grand scheme of things are actually not relevant. And here is why. The popular games such as Street Fighter, such as Bomb, these games get great reviews, raves, and support from at best 30,000, an audience of 30,000 people in the fighting game community. That's going from Japan to, that's like you put in SBO, DreamHack, Stunfest, Gaming, World Game, Evolution, all of the fighting game tournaments throughout the year that support Evolution and anything in Australia. Combine all the gamers that physically attend the event. And those are your numbers. That's your solid audience for your fighting game community. Those numbers are completely insignificant. Now, some people are like, well, Triforce, how are you going to sit there and bash us? Because I'm going to show you guys the numbers that actually matter and what and how the community gouges its own self, which makes absolutely no sense. The numbers that matter are the sales of the game. A lot of people disagree. But I'm talking about business here. I'm not talking about your opinion as in the community. If Capcom games could sell as good as Mortal Kombat's numbers in their games, Capcom would be more inclined to put out a lot more money to support the game. This is how esports works. The reason why League of Legends is where it is, because League of Legends, in terms of its user base, is off the chart. So Riot is like, okay, we're going to support it. We're going to put in money. Mortal Kombat sells Mortal Kombat 9. One game has sold more than vanilla, chocolate, super, and 2012 version of Street Fighter 4 combined. You need all four games and still lose to the first initial sales of Mortal Kombat as a game. So it is nothing for Warner Brothers, who's in league with NetherRealm, to say, here's $33,000 twice. Oh, it's not. A lot of people are not coming out in the numbers of Marvel. Well, here's $16,000 twice. not to mention $10,000 on a PDP national, not to mention $5,000 given to the community. And this is all baby white money because they sell in the game. And the problem here is people only support the Capcom game because of the context behind the content. Let me explain that. If not for Yipes, Daigo, Infiltration, Justin, PR Barron, Sanford, Wolf Chrome, Dominion, Chris D, Filipino Champ, you name him. If not for those players, which is the context, no one cares about content. Mortal Kombat does not need gamers to sell, well, prolific gamers competing to sell and endorse their games because the product is good to begin with. The product does not suck. And I'm sorry, Street Fighter sucks as a game. In terms of balance, terrible balancing issues. And Marvel is the worst fighting game in the modern era. I'll just say that because there are games that can be worse than Marvel. In the modern era, the worst actual fighting game in the modern era. Those games are surviving off of popularity, which is dangerous because if you take those the context away from the content, the game dies. Games like Combat, it is a shame that the community come together in the numbers that Street Fighter scene come in because the scene has the numbers. It really does, but people don't come up behind a good game. So it is not greatly balanced out.
Hey, Triforce, hold your thought right there. Let me, before, because, you know, I just pummeled a whole bunch of people in here. We got the anime guys. I got DC. I got Lord Knight. I got Kelvin and Dio. And also I got Chris Bond from Put That Back.
Yeah, don't worry.
I just don't want you guys, hold on. Everybody shut the fuck up. I'm talking. I just don't want you guys in the anime to think that this is going to continue because I am going to roll over to you guys in a minute. I just don't want you guys to get away from me for tonight.
Sure. I'm getting out of here now. Triforce, I'll be up late. Call me whenever you can. I'll be on Skype the whole time, so whenever you're done, call me. But I, you know, look, I understand what you're saying about the sales purpose, but I'm just saying it is, you know, people don't realize a lot of the stuff. It's so easy to look at a company and say, oh, well, because of this game or that game, it's, you know, this game is going to be whatever. That game. Mortal Kombat 9 was not a bad game. Had a few bugs. It's not like these guys don't know what the fuck the issue was. I'm sure those things have been resolved in Injustice. I mean, and anyone can tell you every game has got some of the most fucking stupid bugs you'll ever see. It is almost impossible to make a fighting game with 0.0 bugs. Get the fuck out of here. And these guys are humans. It was their first attempt, and God knows how long at a tournament style fighting game and an engine they really hadn't used that engine in 2D before, and character designs they hadn't used before. So there were obviously things that are going to come up that, you know, you don't plan for it first. And they try to crucify them for that over Injustice. Not only do those guys work really hard, but they're better to us than any other fucking studio is to their community. And yet you sit here and say, well, fuck those guys and their games. Let me go over to this studio and their games, who are super sketchy, less consistent. Oh, and by the way, they'll treat me like shit. But let me go ahead and bash these guys over here. Yeah, it's absolutely ridiculous. So on that note, I'm gonna let you guys get out. I'm gonna get out of here. Let you guys get to the anime. Triforce will be up pretty late, so call me whenever, man.
Yo, Tom, wait.
Hold on, Tom. Other people in the chat want to talk. In the call want to talk to you.
Tom, before you leave, yeah. Tom. Let me know if Lobo's gonna be in. Is Lobo gonna be in fucking Injustice?
It's what?
Lobo. You know who Lobo is?
I don't know anything about that game. Injustice. I don't know anything about it. I mean, people for some reason assume because I was in NetherRealm for 1 week of Mortal Kombat 9 that all of a sudden I'm this like top secret Injustice guy. I don't know anything about Injustice. People think, oh, Tom, you're not talking about Injustice because you're under NDA. Come off that shit, dog, aka Crimson Shadow. But I'm like, I don't know anything about the game to come off. I mean, I don't know shit. I played it one time at E3, and God, I promise you, the game ain't like that. You know, now. So, I honestly don't know anything about it.
Fuck.
So, I am definitely not the one.
Because I'm not going to play that shit. I'm not going to play that shit until they fucking release Lobo.
Then, Tom, you are the best in the business. That's all I got to say.
Tom, I got to ask you a question. What's your favorite animal?
My favorite animal is a skunk.
Regular dragon.
Thinks as bad as I do in MK9. That's why. All right, so on that note...
That's Derptile's question. You know, before anybody talks, this way he doesn't have to keep asking the same question. When I get to you, just tell me what your favorite animal is so we can get that question out of the way.
So,
what's my favorite anime? It's obviously Fisted and All-Star.
Yo!
Yo,
yo Fisted.
You gotta get on that.
Alright,
I'll be here, so I'll be on, so just call me whenever, man.
Alright, man.
Alright, peace.
James.
Yes, sir.
I guess, you know, since the anime segment is about to start, I'm just going to say a few things and then bounce. First, more people should be playing Chaos Code because that game is godlike, and I hope that it gets a netcode patch so more people can have access to it. That would be nice. So that's my little anime spiel. About MK9, I agree with some of the things that Tom has said, but I don't really think that just because the company developer Circle Jerk amongst the players in person gives them a reason to make bad games. So, you know, I'm not going to really let up on what I'm saying. I don't really care about that sentimental bullshit. I just want a good fighting game, and I don't think that they're going to deliver with Injustice. So I guess we'll just wait and see for me to be proven wrong, I guess. And all the haters in the MK community, you can swallow my dick if you can.
Hold on. I have a question. Just a very simple question. Everyone's entitled to their opinion, so I have nothing against your opinion. It's just a simple question. What is a good fighting game to you?
To me? Like, yes. Like which
if
one is
you,
good?
If you could choose a which game is this, good,
or what needs to be in it for great?
No. If you could use an example today that defines a good fighting game. There's a whole bunch of fighting games out right now. Can you give me an example of which one of them is considered good?
Street Fighter 1.
Out of all of them?
What?
Wait, out of
Street
all
Fighter
of them?
1.
Street Fighter 1.
Street Fighter 1. Fuck off. Street Fighter 1. Street you know Fighter why? 1. Everyone has the same fucking move. Fuck that.
Okay, so games like Karate Chan, Street Fighter 1. Okay,
hold
that
shit.
That
is the most balanced game ever released.
Actually, if you want to talk the most balanced, it actually is the first one, which is Karate Chan.
Why do you guys care about balance so much?
Actually, as a player of both games, I had the world record in actual Street Fighter 1, and I have played Karate Chan.
Ooh, you know,
the games are not balanced. Player 1 side always hits first. If you're playing Street Fighter 1, and someone picks Ken, and I pick Ryu, and in the beginning, we do perfect fireball wars, and we start. My fireball is going to eventually beat yours until you get pushed in the corner and you die. And dragon punches fly? Well, the dragons go through each other, but if you do a hurricane kick to each other, we will always kick Ken out of the hurricane kick. And in Karate Chan, all high moves beat out player 2 high moves. And player 2, all low moves beat out player 1. And guess what? All mid moves beat out player 2. So player 1 has a 2 attack advantage over player 1.
Can
you
stop
feeding
your trolls now?
Yo, shout out. Yo, what up, Hino Good?
Trolls have been fed enough.
There are no balanced games out there. There's no such thing as a complete balanced game. None. You just don't know what games aren't balanced, like the bad stuff in the game or not. In fact, I'm telling you right now, all the testing, whoever was selected to test Injustice, they could have sat there and tested the game for 6 years. When the game comes out, there are going to be problems in the game.
I don't know, Triforce.
I want is Lobo in the fucking game. Can somebody just fucking confirm that for me so I can buy the piece of shit game or not?
No, he's not.
Lobo's in the game.
No, he's not.
If Lobo's in the game, Paco will get my fucking money. If it's not, fucking the rest of this conversation can suck my dick. All right, that's it.
He's not in the game.
If he's not in the game, fuck. I don't want to even talk about this anymore. Fuck.
But Scrooge, but Scrooge, but Scrooge McDuck from DuckTales is in it.
Damn.
Nick, no, Lobo has to be in that fucking game, dude. That nigga is so. He's the only DC character worth my fucking money. Fuck Batman. Fuck Wonder Woman. Fuck Superman. Fuck everyone in DC except Lobo. Nigga, fuck.
So Webster, are you gonna say anything else before you?
Hold on, what was that?
I said, are you gonna say anything else before you leave? Because I'm about to leave too, and I just want to say something real quick.
Well, yeah, Triforce, I don't know, man. I think Tekken is pretty balanced, and if you could tell me an imbalanced character in Tekken, then I'll completely take away my statement. But until you do that, then I don't know. System mechanics.
Balanced character in Tekken 1?
No, Tekken Tag 2. Fuck every
other.
I'm
sure he doesn't know enough about Tekken Tag 2 to give you a real statement.
I'm sure it'll take 10 hours anyway to a statement.
Well, okay. I know Fighting DM. I know Fab. I know Core. I know Blood. The person who studies Tekken the most is Blood Red. He's just not godlike at the game. And I'm telling you right now.
I just want you to tell me an imbalanced character in Tag 2. When you do that, then I'll completely agree with you that there is no such thing as a balanced game. When you tell me that there's an imbalanced character in Tag 2 that is broken.
Everybody is. Fuck that game, dude. But, man, end that conversation, man.
That
game sucks ass. I don't give a shit. Everybody's fucking broken.
It is. I understand that you won't ever be able to beat King Ray Jr. in Tekken. That's okay. You can be salty over Tekken.
Dude, I never even played the fucking game. Fuck that game, dude. It's not worth my fucking time. Why are we even talking about that shit? Fucking Tekken Tag.
Come on, brother. We ain't talking about justice, man. I mean,
listen, man. You talked about how MK9 was shit. I'm telling you, fucking Tekken is even more shitter.
I respect that.
I just read a message. I said, I need to know who's the most imbalanced character in Tekken Tag 2. When he tells me, I'm going to mention it on the show.
I mean, even if it's.
I want to know what game he thinks is the worst.
Even if there's no imbalanced character, doesn't mean the game's perfectly balanced, so.
There's no such thing as a game being perfectly balanced.
I know, that's
no
what I'm saying.
Game.
All right, Triforce, I'm going to put a muzzle on you for 2 seconds. Webster, I'm going to let you fucking close your thing up. So this way Jugs can do his thing and close it up. Going to run a commercial, going to come back with all the anime guys, and we are done with this MK world. and then we're going to get back into the anime world because I need to be edumacated.
All right. All right.
Shout out to the meeting, Triforce.
Haters, all right, haters swallow my dick, as I said before. I will get Injustice, I will be playing it. I'm not paying for that shit, fuck that. I'm not paying for that garbage. I will get it, though. I will play. Hopefully, I am wrong about everything I've said about NRS and their terrible developers and their in the terrible MK community. Other than that, James, I love what you do. Natus, I hope one day you'll grow to love Tekken. Just as much as Tekken loves you.
Fuck no. You fucking love me.
And anime folks, I mean, you guys really rep your shit hard. I respect a lot of your games, especially Guilty Gear, Melty. Melty is godlike.
Shout out to Melty Blood.
Oh, Melty Blood.
Respect my game.
But
shout out to Dead Games.
Wait.
Damn.
It's okay, guys.
Right.
Like an LK. Was like, yo, shout out to Bunty Low. I love that game. And nigga doesn't play that shit no more.
Hey, I got a question for you, anime folks, actually. Do you guys think that BlazBlue CP is going to have, like, a good lifespan in the States, or is it going to die within weeks again?
I don't know. It's just going to be the same shit, probably. Just like, much. Oh, new game, and then people will play, and then whoever sucks is going to quit, and then whoever's good is going to keep playing, and then maybe after 6 or 7 months, after there's a really big tournament, more people will drop off until the next game comes out.
Hmm.
Or maybe Arc System Works will actually try to do something.
I want to say it'll have better, it'll have better impressions, first impressions, since it's a lot faster as a game, especially since that was, like, one of the main, like, complaints that a lot of people had.
With Persona?
Well,
it's still
Persona is the
game
best game we had. Persona is the best game we fucking have.
Yeah, I'm not saying it's bad. I'm saying it's dying still. What's your point? It's fast. Like, the new BlazBlue is going to be faster. It's still going to die, just like every other BlazBlue, just like Persona.
Okay. All right. Thanks for answering my question. But yeah, let me just finish. Costner, I wish you wouldn't say that. He was in the chat and he just said, why do you invite Digi? He's not even part of the MK community. That's bullshit, dude. Just because I don't agree with everything you guys fucking say or what you guys expect me to say or want to hear does not mean I'm not part of this community.
No, because so you think so Tekken's godlike. That's why.
That is, I swear, you hate Tekken there, I swear. But other than that, thanks for having me on the show, guys. Haters like Costner, you can fall off a cliff, and anime folks take over and run shit. Thank you. Take care, guys.
All right, man.
All right.
Wait, what did you, you going to ask him a question?
No, I didn't want to ask him a question.
Oh, okay. Go ahead. Jugs, what are you going to say?
Yeah, I was just going to say, as far as what Triforce is saying, in my opinion, like, I'm not going to give an example of a game that I think, you know, is the best or balanced or whatever, but I think balance is overrated, and if there's one thing in a fighting game that, like, if there was only one thing you could pick, in my opinion, it would be skill gap. If there's skill gap, the game would be good and successful in tournaments. And I just want to tell all you anime guys and everybody watching, get Injustice. Just at least give it a chance. If you don't like it, you know, fine, but just
If I don't like it, are you going to buy it for me? Buy it back for me?
Yes. If Lobo's not in the game, will you buy it for me?
No, I will not.
I'm not gonna buy it. All right.
No, I'm gonna buy it. I'm buying it.
Everybody wants to try that story mode, man. Story mode's gonna be off the hook.
I don't care.
Starfire.
People, once again, I don't give a fuck about none of the other characters in that game.
Oh, Starfire's in that game. I'll play her. Yeah.
Have you been paying attention to any of the news that's coming out? NRS is definitely paying attention to what the community is saying. So, I mean, I just as a fighting game player, I want you guys to just give it a try. Anyway,
yeah.
Thanks for having me on the show, and I'm out, guys.
Bye, man.
Night.
All right.
Later.
All right. Natus, I'm going to run a commercial quick. You run the other commercial behind it. I got to take a piss.
No.
And then I'll be back, and I'll be back with the anime, guys. Sorry for the delay, guys. Twitch was all fucked up. It slowed everything down today.
Don't worry, guys, I'll cue you back in when the commercial's over. Just try to be mic quiet.
Commercial natives. Natus?
Yeah, yeah. All
right. You're running that commercial, right?
All right, so we're good. Let's go.
All right. All right, guys. Make sure you can get down the final round if you get an opportunity.
I'm going.
That's good shit, man. I'm glad, you know, anime is going to get represented, I hope, much better than it's been in the past. Wow, my Twitter thing is going fucking nuts.
Has it been bad in the past?
You know what? Not that it's been bad, you know, and this is something we discussed last time. It's the segregation that goes on in the tournaments where you guys are kind of put in the back of the bus. Now, I don't know if you like that, you know. I mean, I think that, you know, anime games as a whole should start getting put up on the main stage just like Street Fighter and Mortal Kombat and everything else.
I don't think that's discrimination, though. That's just us doing the events our way, and, you know, our main guy in the Northeast who does it wants to help the tournaments run in one day, especially since we even get support from places like Canada that come out, so they can leave whenever they need to on Sunday without needing to stay the whole thing to watch finals or if they have players in the finals or such. So part of it is wanting to get the events for us done in on Saturday.
What about exposing it to community? I mean, because if you go on like Spooky Stream, you get exposing it to like 10,000 people.
Oh,
and maybe you might want to bring more players into the scene because you got more people watching it.
All right.
I mean, it's just people watching it. If they really care, I really feel that they could come to us. It's not like we don't make ourselves available. It's not like we don't advertise. It's not like we're in the same hotel as other people.
No, okay? I agree with you on that. As far as at the scene, you know, at the venue, people, like, I mean, I go into the anime room and I watch you guys play, but a lot of people don't, you know, and a lot of people on stream don't really understand the whole, you know, anime fighting game as far as compared to like a Street Fighter, you know.
All right. Oh, sorry, James.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
No, I was going to say one thing is, for instance, I'm going to throw names out here. I'm a fucking asshole and I'm devil's advocate. I don't give a fuck who I name and I'll fucking do it.
It's on blast out for a reason.
Yep. You got guys like your own boy CD Jr. Like, this for instance, there was a conversation with CD Jr. asking him, like, you know, has he ever played anything beside any 09er games? CD Jr. goes, no. They're all random button mashing games. We asked him, what's the deepest game you've ever played? We asked him, was Guilty Gear any good? He goes, no, it has no death. I think it's a stupid game. I looked at CD Jr. and all logic. I looked at CD Jr. and all logic went out the fucking window when I heard that story. I was like, I'm fucking done. And I'm not even part of the anime community. I want to throw that out there. Like, I go to any tournament. Like, I play Street Fighter 4. I've played fucking Turbo. I've played any and all games that I've enjoyed. And when I hear people say, "Oh shit, yo, this game doesn't have death and logic, and he's never even touched the game," I'm like, okay, your fucking opinion is null and void, bro.
You know what you gotta understand.
Hold on, wait. Quick question. I got a question for you guys that came from one of the guys in the chat. The question is for the anime guys. Why don't you guys play a game like Naruto?
Well, I don't even know what that game is. What the fuck like, is that? It's like a GameCube game.
There's a lot of Naruto games even out there in the first place, but I think there's a common misconception of what the term anime seems to mean to people. Anime just became the slang for the combination of the Arc System Works games and then the games that are far off into that area, mm-hmm. such as Melty Blood and Arcana Heart gameplay-wise.
So Air Dashes, pretty much.
Stuff like that. Yeah. Well, for the most part, but then you get confusing on what actually is an anime game. Then you call Marvel the anime game? You call Marvel an anime game, even though there's Marvel's no anime actually game. In it?
Naruto is actually an anime.
Let's get down to the aesthetics. Basically, aesthetic-wise, Naruto isn't a fighting game generated towards the basics of fighting anime games. Like, it's just a fighting. It's like, it's not, it's its own game. It's like a mash. It's like a button mashing game. Like, you just press buttons and shit happens.
That's a new one. Though.
That sounds like Marvel.
That's most
of the modern games.
They're completely different beasts.
There were Naruto games that
and
that
they have
2D fighters.
Yeah. They had their own communities. The Wii ones and the GameCube ones. They had their own separate communities.
Yeah, the PlayStation ones were actually the PS2 ones were actually able to be made into tournament games because they had like fighting game aesthetics. Like they had footsies, they had things in where you can situate yourselves.
Uh-huh. What about the most recent game that came out from Naruto?
Ninja Storm 3? That's a party game masher kind of game. Not really a fighting game like that.
But you gotta admit, the fucking game looks fucking sick.
No, it looks cool.
Man, it looks nice.
It looks cool, but it plays like ass.
Yeah.
I haven't had a chance to play the new one yet.
It's just mashing a button. I don't know. I'm not a deep Naruto player. It's not good.
I mean, it's gotta have some kind of semblance towards like a traditional fighting game in the first place.
It's one attack button.
Yeah, like Naruto Ultimate Heroes for PS2, you had footsies. You actually had a lot of techniques that went into the game. Like you could you had the button locking, which was amazing. I thought that was a great addition. Like you fucking screwed over. You were rewarded for combos into like situations where you had to learn things.
Yeah, and the timing needed for KMJ and all that
stuff. I have a question to anime players. What do you guys think is actually required in order for some of the mainstream players that predominantly play the Capcom games, what do you think the developers need to incorporate for, say, someone like Justin Wong say, you know what, I think I'm going to give this game a chance and actually like go into the anime room and play your games?
Nothing?
Yeah.
There will never be anything like that that'll ever happen.
It's already been done. There's people who have crossed over from anime, like take for instance, it's Marlin Pie, huge. Like I knew Marlin Pie since he was 14 years old. We were playing Guilty Gear in his living room in New Jersey, and look at him now. Like, there's crossover people all the time. People who cross over from anime games into Street Fighter, like from RF. Like he's one of the top Sagat players in the world, but you know he came from Guilty Gear. You know, like there's so many different people. Dogra, like he's was one of the best RoboKai players in Guilty Gear, but like he's a sick Street Fighter player. And these
Inoue, players, Kazunoko.
Kazunoko is Inoue, and it happens. You see it more in Japan than you see it in the U.S. just because of the separation. Yeah, money is one.
No, factor, it's just money.
It's a separation of the communities, and the communities are just they're not. If you're in the Japanese arcade, every community is in the same arcade. It's like when you have a really big arcade, this community is just. They just flush together. You might be sitting right next to the Street Fighter cast where the Street Fighter community is there. But in the U.S., you don't have that. You have people online playing each other. They have their own communities, their own forum, you know, their own media outlets. And even in tournaments, they have their own freaking tournament room. So those communities aren't interacting. They aren't talking to each other and saying, hey, check this game out. You know, I play this game. You play this game. You know, that game's sick. You can't just look over your shoulder of a BlazBlue cab and see a Street Fighter cab and be like, yo, what just happened? And talk to the person right next to you. So I think there has to be some kind of coming together, more of a reaching out for people who have become mainstream to the communities that are, you know, looking to make that happen. You know, like when Spooky started streaming our, like, gamepad bi-weeklies in Brooklyn. You know what I mean? He started streaming out of his basement, streaming multiple.
Yeah, he was doing the poverty games.
Yeah, he started that. And when it comes to anime games and anime games getting exposure or anime players getting exposed on his streams, when they cross over into the games that he's streaming now, he goes out of his way, you know, to represent where they came from and let people know, like, oh, this guy is a sick anime player. His execution is godlike. You know, he's a really smart player. He came from Guilty Gear. He came from Melty Blood. Like, Spooky makes the effort to do that because he remembers where he came from. So that's one outlet you have. That's one opportunity you have right there. And, like, frankly, like, what I think people need to do is to, you know, you don't have to branch out into a mainstream game to make a name for anime games.
No, but you gotta, you know, and like I said, like you said, you know, the Japanese culture is different as far as, you know, everybody's kind of smashed. It's basically smashed together the whole community.
Exactly.
There's no reason because we don't have arcades, you know, they're dead.
You
know, and with that, there's got to be a way, you know, for, you know, and once again, you know, and correct me if I'm wrong. When I hear Capcom Unity, it makes me cringe. Because why is it got to be Capcom Unity as compared to fucking FGC Unity?
Like, what one thing I'd like to always say is, like, I hear people say the anime scene, like, that's already a way to segregate. That's like, it's just the same way. It's just segregation in its own way. It's like, oh, you guys are the anime scene. And I'm like, what the fuck? Am I not part of the same community? I don't play anime, but
I know. No, I mean, it's, you know what it is? You know, and I understand where you're coming from that, but I got to disagree with you because I look at it and say, look, you know, you are from Nebraska, I'm from New York, but we are part of the United States. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with a term that groups a group of people together, but the overall picture has to be looked at, and you have to understand that, yeah, it's an anime community within the fighting game, or an anime scene within the fighting game community. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the exposure, you know, you guys have better turnouts than we do, you know, MK players, for their tournaments. And that's something that people don't really understand. They think like, oh, you know, 8 people showed up to this. No. You guys get 100 to 200 people all the time. Mm-hmm. You know, or if not better. So, I mean, MK does battle with, you know, getting 128 people to an event.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so theoretically speaking, you guys are looking down on the MK community as far as turnout goes.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
I was about to say, like, I'm not looking down on...
Yeah, well, yeah, I don't mean it looking down on it as a community, but, I mean, if you were to put everybody, you know, from top to bottom as far as turnout, you're above them, you know, so, you know, and you're above a lot of other games that are out there, too. But you're still kind of put, like I said, you're still kind of put in the back of the bus mentality. It's like, oh, you know what, you know, and if you look at the rooms, Capcom's got the big room at every tournament, MK's got the next one, and then the anime gets the third one, which is usually the smallest. You know, I mean, and like I said, this ain't nothing against the tournament organizers, but this is just how it's developed over the years. You know, it's just the way it happened, but there has to come a time where, you know, I'd love to see, you know, and I know, I guess it's Dio or Diando.
Just say Dio or Andrew.
All right.
Either one of those.
Like you were saying that, like, getting it done in one day. But still your top four, top whatever, you know, give the guys 15 minutes of fame. Expose the top players, you know, on stream, on the main stream, you know, stream by Spooky.
For me personally, I was just going by most of the logic of what our main guy is. I actually usually do try, such as with ECT last year. I was the one who actually pushed for Guilty Gear to be on the main stage for top 8, which ended up happening on Saturday night after the money match. So I generally do push for it for when it's available, but I don't have actual control over our theme or content. I'm not sure what's going on 100% with ECT, at least this year, since I'll actually be in charge of that one for anime. So we'll see how the stream schedule looks for that as it goes along. But I feel ultimately, in terms of exposing the game, that anyone who just says, oh, this looks cool, I'll give it a try, just from that, without actually having tried to seek it out or stuff, chances are is probably never going to either compete on a professional level or just flat out quit the game quickly when, you know, they just find it doesn't meet their expectations because it looked pretty.
I mean, like,
James, hold on. I got a question that just came in. This is for the anime guys again. Why are there no IRL pop-ups in the anime scene? And I feel like hate will make things more hype.
Because we have at Onagai Roku-chan.
Yo, Onagai Roku-chan.
Yeah, we have Roku. Like,
no, actually there used to be a lot of pop-offs in the Melty Blood scene. And then, like, the best Melty Blood player, like, he was the best at the time he left the U.S., he used to talk so much shit. No. And then when I started winning in games, I don't really like talking shit because if I lose, then people talk shit to me, and I don't like that. So I just say nothing and win.
Yeah, people don't understand, like, Guilty Gear community still talks shit. Like, back when Guilty Gear was in EVO, like, back years, Guilty Gear was at EVO, there was no term anime fighters. It was just, this is Guilty Gear. Even when
Blood
was coming up, there was Multi Bug wasn't called an anime fighter. That didn't start until Blaze Blue was released. But at the same time, like, Guilty Gear had players like had New York scene versus Midwest versus West Coast, and people like Marn and Flash were popping off like all the time. There was money matches going down. People were hyped, and that still happens in tournament cities. I think Guilty Gear is more, might be a little bit more like visual and, you know, focal when it comes to people popping off and getting hyped for things that are going on, just because of like the kind of players that were in the community and the kind of players that, you know, kind of branched out into other communities, like say like Marvel and such.
The East Coast is also still shit talking, but no one else seems to respond when it comes to anime. They're always shitting on West Coast, especially.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Well, I mean, is that hype something that you guys want, or is it, I mean, like I said, I'm trying to figure out, do you guys enjoy the isolation, or do you want, you know, you want the hype, you want to get the game out there, or are you guys content with what you got?
I don't know about everyone else. That other stuff is like not important to me really. It's what's important to me is like people come to tournaments and I have like people to play. I honestly just want to find the best players and just beat them all, so I don't care about, like, exposure or whatever. I just want to fucking play people and beat people.
But you can't even do that now.
Yeah, it's difficult when you don't have people to play, you know. And I think part of getting people to play is getting the game exposed. And you're always going to have players who are going to be more concentrated in growing their community or streaming media and creating content. And then you're going to have players who are concerned with their, you know, individual performance, and that's how they get their like enjoyment out of it, is their individual performance in that competition. So I mean, everybody has to do their part. If you're more somebody who you might not be that concerned with your individual performance at tournaments, and you might be more interested in doing content creation or reaching out to other like media outlets to get the game more exposure, then I think you should follow your calling and do what you think is going to be best for yourself and for the community. So like, everybody can't be expected to be the promoter, to be the hype man, you know, to start promoting for tournaments. Everybody has to play their own part, and if you feel like you're going to be better as a gamer and individually, then that's what you got to do. You know, like Chris G, he cares about his individual performance. Like, that's what gave him his name. That's what gets people hyped, and that's what brings people to watch Marvel sometimes, is that they know Chris G is going to be playing. He's not Maximilian. He's not creating YouTube like content to get people interested in a specific game. Everybody has their own specific part to play.
Yeah, and it definitely needs, you know, more people to be involved. I think some people take it for granted, and they're like, oh, well, Skullgirls came's out, and it's like, damn, why is this game not getting supported? And, you know, it's not just the players, you know, you have to have content streamers, you have to have, you know, the spectators and stuff like that, the media outlets. I mean, there's a multiple variety of elements. It's kind of like a major sport. If nobody bothered watching, like, football and stuff, it's just like, well, damn, like, how come no one's watching our team?
Exactly. And I think it's a little bit lopsided right now, where everybody's concerned with their individual performance. And that's nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying
that I don't think that many people are concerned about their individual performance.
Yeah. No, we might have better players.
Not performance, the support level. The support level for their games.
Yeah, so there just needs to be more support. People who take you step up and have more support for the game.
Because I think the best, a unique thing about the anime community is like not a lot of people travel really. So what happens is I like traveling a lot, because like I said, I just want to play people. So what happens at tournaments is usually like I'm going to go to final round, right? I'm probably the only East Coast player who's going to go to play Persona. So what happens every other time I go is that anytime I play one of the top South players, they all circle around me and just yell shit in my ear while I'm playing. I play in New York, so it's not a big deal.
Yeah.
I'm just like, whatever, it's not New York level. You guys are just yelling shit.
Yeah, you're lucky I'm not there wailing in your ear next to you. You fucking suck, LK!
No, that's standard anyway. That's everywhere in the country. You're not special.
Yeah, but I do it so much better than everyone else. That's the point.
What I think we need to do is actually get Jordal on the stream right now, because he's...
We need to get Jordal, and
we need to get PK Tezen on the stream so we can get these content creators and people who are actually giving our games exposure and get their opinion on what could be done maybe a little bit more, and maybe even what can be done to give them some help so they're not...
I think what
Jordo will never, ever, ever come on.
I just oh, wait, what are you talking about? I was video chatting with Jordo yesterday.
Oh, my God.
On a stream?
Yeah. We were video
chatting. Now, let me ask you this. Now, why is that you would say that about him?
He hates going on streams in general.
Jordo is a social butterfly. You guys...
Wow, what
he mostly does is he uploads videos not just for our majors, but he takes videos off of NicoVid, which is pretty much Japanese YouTube, and puts them
and
up.
And he won Apex.
Yeah. Okay. But yeah, and he doesn't like the attention that comes from YouTube. Story short.
Yeah, Jordo's a shot.
Even when everyone is like on his side, like, he got called for a stream in a 6 persona match of Summer Jam, and everyone is hyped because they like him, they wanted to support him, and he just wants to kill everyone in the room, and he won his match, too, and everything.
Godlike.
I hit the guy he was playing by accident in the head, dude. I felt really bad.
Wow. Shout out to fucking Futanari Nerd Josh in the chat, too.
I got a question for you guys that came over Twitter. It says, if you want to expand the scene, what new things would you be willing to do to what new things would you implement to make your scene grow?
Company support from an actual marketing for one from the first parties that release our games, especially since we used to get none just when everyone else was getting none too, pretty much before streams blew up, Street Fighter 4 blew up, and all that. Mm-hmm. And then in the beginning with BlazBlue, we actually got quite a bit of it from Axis Games, who publish the games from Arc System Works in the U.S., and now Arc System Works supposedly wants to move to the U.S. and stop going through Axis Games. So now that leaves Guilty Gear and BlazBlue in a huge hole. Like, Arc System Works finally got an English Twitter account a couple of months ago, and that's just been the start, maybe 1 month ago. Mm-hmm. And as far as Persona goes, that's been done through Atlas, and they've done some nice things, no doubt, some pop bonuses and T-shirts, but, you know, it's definitely not on the level, I feel, that a lot of other companies do. And
it's not even close.
Yeah. You know, so they've done something, at least, which is more than I can say for Arc System Works, but what the level of support is definitely not as much as it is for Capcom or NetherRealm Studios or a Namco,
I mean, there's always a plethora of gameplay vids, I feel, for these games, but when it comes to actual, you know, a consistent weekly based show where, you know, people who are knowledgeable about the games are talking about it or are having sessions, it's not there. You know, there's no Mike Ross and Gutex of anime, you know. I mean, recently we had House of Cracks Bum doing sessions for KOF, and that was great. And, you know, we've been talking to him about, you know, maybe doing something for Guilty Gear when the new one comes out. And, you know, like, Bum's really put himself out there for the KOF community, and, you know, the KOF community has responded, you know, with great numbers and, you know, great support for him. So I think that's one example of somebody doing something great, you know, reaching out to other communities, you know, and using their ability to reach other people. I think that needs to happen for, you know, for the anime community. There needs to be some kind of show, some kind of content where people can just tune in and just gain some knowledge and maybe gain some interest for the things that are going, not just gameplay. I mean, it would be great, like, Andrew and I have been talking, you know, about streaming and getting equipment to do, like, you know, streams, since, you know, we play every, like, Friday and Saturday, all of New York is playing at one location. Man. So
that can
play
Sunday
great.
If you come to my place, I'm just saying.
Yeah, this is. I'm looking at Jaxo on stream, and Jaxo's like, "You guys need Capcom people to come in and promote your game." Sign
There's
up
a really easy way.
Game.
To make money that shit.
Fuck off, my nigga! Like, seriously, that shit does not work all the time, yo. Like, that shit does not work. Nobody gives a fuck if Justin comes plays a game. Let them be sheep. It's not
Chris
sheep, yo.
Chris G played.
How many
Chris
new players
played?
Did Chris G bring into Persona?
Chris G played Persona for like a week, and then that nigga was done after he got
bought.
And
then he was out.
No, more than a week.
Yeah, he was done after Summer Jam specifically. I don't know if you remember.
No,
yeah. Yeah. Yo, I don't give a fuck who sign-offs on whatever game. I'm going to play a game if I like it or not.
Thank you.
Doesn't matter. Like, fuck. Am I
yeah,
Chris
but you know what?
Bitch?
But you know what? My thing is, like, for me, like, I've gone and I've watched matches. But, you know, I mean, I know BlazBlue, Guilty Gear. I don't know. What's the other ones that you guys are playing right now that are like...
Persona
is
the big game right now. Yeah, that is the game. BlazBlue is a piece of shit.
Now, you guys traditionally bounce from game to game, or is it one dies, another lasts? I mean, how does that work?
There's a different story for every game. So, like, Guilty Gear is the best, like, community of all the anime games, in my opinion, because everyone cared and everyone tried really hard, and it was great. And then I don't know what happened to GG. Melty Blood is shit, and BlazBlue is okay, and Persona
actually
okay.
Sorry.
So what happens with BlazBlue and everything, like after SF4 came out, it's like any new anime game, it's like, oh, comes out, popular for a while, X is broken, and then people don't want to play beside a few people. And then rinse and repeat. And then Melty Blood is every other version to PC, and PC sucks ass. So
exactly.
PC and comes out, it's just a, it's
really absolutely
hurt. Terrible. It's so fucking bad.
That really, really
version
hurt.
As like the main tournament for like a tournament is so bad.
Yeah, Melty died. Melty killed itself.
Melty killed itself.
No, Frenchman.
No, Melty killed itself too.
Now wait. Now when you're